In the New Testament, we read of two different men named Philip. The first Philip was one of the 12 original apostles chosen by Jesus. The second Philip was a young man who appears in the book of Acts. And although we might expect that the apostle Philip would get the most biblical press, in truth we hear very little of him. It is the second Philip, the one who figures prominently in the book of Acts, who gets the most attention in the Holy Scriptures. There are two great evangelistic efforts of Philip related in Scripture. The first is when he went to the city of Samaria and preached Christ to these people that nobody else seemed to want to touch in those days. Philip was used powerfully by God to impact that city. Many Samaritans became followers of Jesus as a result, and there were many healings and miracles as well. A second dramatic story told in Acts is when Philip was told by the Holy Spirit to go out into the wilderness where he would meet a powerful Ethiopian official traveling in his chariot. This man had a respect for God and was reading the passage in Isaiah which speaks of Jesus' death for the sins of the world, what we call Isaiah 53 today. Philip asked the man if he understood what he was reading, and when the Ethiopian confessed he had no clue, Philip was invited up into his chariot where he conducted a Bible study about Jesus and led the man to faith in Christ. We hear of Philip only once more after this. In the 21st chapter of Acts, Luke describes one of the Apostle Paul's journeys and states, "On the next day, we who were Paul's companions departed and came to Caesarea and entered the house of Philip the evangelist, who was one of the seven, and stayed with him." I like that. Even though some years have passed and Philip is now a family man with four daughters, Luke still refers to him as Philip the evangelist. His heart, his ministry, and his passion have not changed. He is and always will be Philip the evangelist. As such, this man is a great model for those of us who would win souls to Jesus, whether we think of ourselves as evangelists or not. One of the greatest lessons we can learn has to do with his subject matter as he attempts to win men and women to Jesus. In his two great evangelistic efforts described in the Bible, we don't have to wonder what was at the heart of his preaching and sharing. We're told plainly. In bringing the gospel to Samaria, we read these words, "Then Philip went down to the city of Samaria and preached Christ to them." And in speaking to the Ethiopian, the Bible tells us, "Then Philip opened his mouth, and beginning at this scripture, preached Jesus to him." This anointed evangelist got the message exactly right, and that message was Jesus Christ. He didn't waste time or dilute his preaching with peripherals or extraneous concepts. He got to the heart of the matter, and he did it quickly. He preached Jesus Christ, his life, his death, his resurrection, and his salvation by grace through faith. Pastors and all Christians today could learn a lot from Philip. The Apostle Paul was another man who knew precisely where the power to transform lives lay. He wrote, "I'm not ashamed of the gospel of Christ, for it is the power of God to salvation for everyone who believes." Another thing Philip did exactly right was that he opened his mouth. Sometimes we suppose we can simply be nice and people will run to Jesus and get saved because of our niceness. But the truth is there are plenty of sinners who are nice. We must by all means show love and kindness to men and women, but we must also open our mouths. The gospel of Jesus Christ must be spoken and written and sung about and preached and shared. Then, and only then, will people come to that blessed place experienced by the Ethiopian and which has the power to confer eternal life, that place expressed by his simple words, "I believe that Jesus Christ is the Son of God."